He's not coming, Abigail.
He came yesterday, didn't he? And the day before?
He'll come.
Let's just leave.
Ruth, let's just see if he comes.
I have to go to the bathroom.
Hurry, he'll be here.
No, he won't.
Hop on, Sugar.
I have my own bike.
Where you work sometimes. Now, do you believe me?
Babies?
All in a row. Jars of apricot jam.
Well, what happened to that one?
It's gone.
Who was first for the checkup? You promised if I showed you the jars. Something's wrong.
Hi, I'm Claire Mullins. I'll be substituting today. Standing ovation won't be necessary.
Ruth's getting married. Where's the bride?
What's wrong? What's going on? Is it off? Is the wedding off?
Claire, it happened last night. I guess in all the confusion, nobody thought to call you.
Yeah, I tried to call this morning, but it was too late.
What happened last night?
There was a car accident last night, Claire. And, Ruth passed away.
Come on. So how does it feel being back?
I always felt cheated having to leave here. No? Like somebody had robbed me of my childhood.
This is your home anyway, Claire. Your real home.
I have nothing but the best memories of you guys and this place.
Step one.
Change the subject, please.
You know, Ruth was a teacher like you.
No, not like me. I was teaching high school, substitute teaching. Squeaky shoe got more attention than I did.
Yeah, but that's all you ever wanted to do, right? Same as Ruth. Do you remember how the two of you used to wear those whistles around your necks?
Yeah, but it never clicked for me like it did for Ruth.
Maybe it wasn't you.
What do you mean?
Maybe you just weren't meant to teach teenagers.
You know, Ruth's class is pretty busted up over what happened.
Yeah, they really need somebody.
Yeah. And maybe so do you.
Maybe you've been teaching the wrong kids.
college in Bloomington and then California.
And you taught in Chicago?
Well, first in Oakland and then in Phoenix. Mm. We moved to Chicago after my mom died.
Somebody chasing you?
When you're uprooted at a young age, it sort of defines you.
Well, I always thought that that a person defines herself. So where are you from?
Oh, right here, Mr. Wyatt. I went to this very school. Mr. Kelso.
Hmm.
God, he's still here.
Yeah, I think Mr. Kelso won't retire until he's buffed this linoleum down to its foundation. You know, I want to give you a little warning. I think it's going to be a little rough for you at first. See, you're replacing a very popular teacher. Ruth Spear's death was very sudden, very unexpected. The kids were very attached to her, still a little heartbroken. I think the toughest part's going to be earning their trust. They're going to be a little skittish about getting real close to anybody again. You're a very qualified teacher, and that's what we need right now. How long you stay is, well, it's up to you. But, you got the job if you want it. Welcome back.
Okay.
Okay, it is. Claire Mullins.
Mr. Kelso, you remember me?
Back then, you used to track crud up and down on my clean floors. I hope you outgrown it.
I'll be careful. Yep.
Are you married?
Nope. Any other questions? Uh-huh.
Do you have a boyfriend?
I have a fish.
Can we wear makeup to school?
What makes you think you can be a teacher?
Well, I became a teacher, Kendra, because we all grow older, and one day we all leave this place like Miss Spear.
But you're not Miss Spear.
True, but I think I know how she must have felt. Like, the only important thing that we leave behind are children, and I just want to have something to do with who those children become. You really miss her, don't you, Kendra?
She was all right.
I know I do. She and I were very close friends when we were your age. We went to this very school together. She was a special woman, and it would be foolish of me to think that I could replace her, because I couldn't. Could I, Kendra? So I won't even try. I'm not here to replace your teacher. The time that she spent with you will always be with you. And the things that she taught you will always be with you, too. I'd just like to finish what she began. Yeah?
Yeah, but aren't you just another substitute?
No. I think I'll stay.
What do you think? And guess what?
You get your very own room. I think we're gonna be happy here.
He looks funny.
Yeah, but at least has an excuse to stink like a fish.
Marlis.
Sorry.
Yes, fish can stink, but can they smell?
For his sake? I hope not.
Can fish breathe? Air, I mean.
Kendra?
No, fish breathe water.
No way.
Yeah, well, you did when you were a little baby inside your mother's stomach.
I did?
But how do fish breathe?
With gills.
That's right. Okay, everybody seated? Let's crack the spelling books.
Aww.
Yeah, come on.
Yes.
Page 10. Okay, where were we?
Recess. You know, you're supposed to tell us if it's right to go.
That's great. I'm doing great.
Kids as possible. I'm here to work.
Did you see him? Okay, I'd like to talk about one or two things before we get started. Can anyone tell me what the word tolerance means? What's that?
It's you.
Let me see. Who brought this in?
Evan. Turn it over.
Where did you get this? Where?
I found it, really. It was on the backstop, it was.
So you all right?
What?
And it wasn't all that bad, was it?
Pardon?
Your first week. You look a little wiped. Back, you look very wiped.
I'm fine.
You always felt this special love for children?
I'm sorry. This must look really bad. It's just that, I have some unpleasant memories connected to this place.
I mean, this school?
You know, I thought I was over them, but being back here.
You know, most kids would rather be anywhere else but here, locked up inside all day. Not exactly inspiring to learn that your teacher feels the same way.
Oh, no. I mean, this is where I want to be. It's where I've always wanted to be. Mm-hmm. Look, if I seem a little wound up, it's It's only because I care too much.
No, don't. I mean, you can't cross busy streets for them and eat their lima beans. You have to leave some of the growing up to the kids.
Careful there.
You're only supposed to want to run him over, not actually do it.
I didn't. I didn't even see him. Mr. Kelso, Ruth Spears' accident, it happened right near here, didn't it?
About a half a block up. She was just getting off school, about this time of day.
Kids all over the street here.
I know, I'm sorry. I didn't see her.
Well, watch it. Come on, honey.
Claire, really? It couldn't be Milo because he's dead. He drowned, remember? He tried to swim across the river, but he didn't know how.
He didn't necessarily drown. He sank. He vanished.
If he were still alive, he'd be 6'6" and drool on himself a lot.
He's still a little kid.
Now you're really making sense. You are being ridiculous.
I know.
It just looked so much like him.
What you saw was just a memory. It's all come galloping up suddenly because you've come back here.
Maybe.
Put the image down. Put it where it belongs, somewhere deep down. I'm gonna make a cup of tea. Would you like a cup of chamomile tea? Okay.
Do you have a picture of him? Do you have a picture of Milo? I don't remember this. Where is this?
You don't remember?
It's a party. Whose?
Hers. It's May, Claire.
Oh my God.
How could I forget May? You see how long ago it was?
Look at us.
Look how young we were. Is it beginning to sink in how weird you're being?
Yeah, but what about this?
This is just your students messing around. They're just trying to give the new teacher a hard time. They don't like you, am I right?
I don't know. They may resent me a little for trying to replace Ruth.
It's not like people in this town don't know what happened to May. Or us. It's just some bad kids being mean. Things are going your way here for a change. Let them.
I am.
I still can't believe that you are teaching in our old classroom.
I know. It's so weird. I mean, were we ever that young?
God. Don't think I don't understand you. Just the thought of Milo is enough to hurt.
Yeah, thanks.
Call me after school tomorrow.
Okay, bye.
Claire Mullins?
Yes?
I'm Lieutenant Parker. It's Deputy Tibbetts. Mind if we come in?
No, is everything okay?
Thank you. Well, now, looks like you've been doing some unpacking. You just move in?
Yes.
You know Miss Abigail Scott?
I do.
Can you tell me when was the last time you saw her?
Oh, my God, nothing's happened to Abigail.
Yeah. We were talking to her neighbors, and they said they saw you over at her place earlier this evening.
Yes, I was there. We're friends. What's this about?
Well, we don't rightly know yet.
What do you mean you don't know? What's going on? Where's Abby? Is she okay?
She's disappeared.
What do you mean, disappeared?
Well, we're keeping our hopes up, but in all honesty, judging by the condition of a place, it doesn't look too good. For right now, we're assuming there's been some kind of foul play. You wouldn't have any idea where she could have gone, would you?
No, no.
You two didn't have any argument, disagreement, or fight, did you?
No, my God, of course not. We're friends.
Good friends?
Yes.
Uh-huh. I see. Well, one more time, Miss Mullins, as you may be the last person to have seen Abigail Scott, do you know if she had any enemies? Anybody that might want to do us some harm? You think now. Is there anything else you can tell us that might help? Anything at all?
By this morning, and you know, they wanted to know what happened, but I didn't tell him because I didn't want him to think that I've gone completely nuts. Milo killed Abigail.
Who?
Milo. You know, Milo.
Okay. Milo Jeter? You mean the boy that drowned?
Yeah, he's still a kid.
Claire.
Oh, you don't believe me. Neither did Abigail.
Look, they told me they couldn't be sure about what happened to Abby. You know, they came to me with questions too, and I told them I didn't know anything, but there is one thing I do know. Milo Jeter had nothing to do with anything.
He killed Ruth too.
Claire, I haven't wanted to say this, but I feel like I should now. Remember how after May's accident, you couldn't get out of bed and you couldn't leave the house until the day you moved? I know you said that it was for your cut to heal, but we all knew, Claire, that you went a little crazy. I don't know, maybe that's happening again.
I gotta go to school.
What, are you kidding? In your state? You know, think about the kids, Claire.
I am thinking about the kids. They're still messed up over what happened to Ruth. You know, they need me.
Do you care about your job?
Yes. I can't be late.
No. Do you care about your job?
Yeah. Care about the kids.
Okay, then do yourself a favor. Don't tell anybody about that Milo stuff. Okay?
Sugar.
Don't talk to me like that. Who told you to put cards in your spokes? And where did you get that slicker? You didn't have that on yesterday.
It's mine.
this. Who did this? Who? Oh. Evan. Now, I know you know who did this. You tell me right now who did this.
No one was here when we got here. I was already here.
Okay, go get Mr. Kelso now. Okay. Go.
You run like a girl.
Huh?
Huh? Nice raincoat.
It scared her.
Good.
Oh, Mr. Kelso, finally. Could you take care of this, please? Cover it or something. And you might want to keep your eyes open for the kind of trash that would do something like this. I mean, we do have doors and locks around here, don't we?
That looks to be the work of a kid.
I know.
But this is a school, ma'am. Don't make sense to lock kids out of school.
Just please find something to cover it with.
How about a map? Aren't you going out today?
What? Yes. Yes, of course.
Claire, what's wrong?
Would you stand by me at recess?
Yes, I will. Sorry about Abigail.
You remember her, too?
Recess. Nothing to it, huh?
Yeah. I guess I'm getting the hang of it.
Come on, hurry up. Quickly, come on. Come on.
Come on, everybody, come on, let's go. Come on, let's go.
Don't you have a kiss for an old friend?
Mother coming to pick you up like this. How are you doing?
Oh, God, Marion. I scared my kids to death. I feel so bad, you know? I mean, I was hired to calm them down, and then I just completely scared the hell out of them.
Miss, this is a grammar school.
Yeah, noticed.
You can't smoke in here.
Oh, well, that's good, because we're going. Thanks. You didn't tell anybody about that Milo stuff, did you?
No. You told me not to. You were right. And that would be playing right into his hand. I mean, he's a very clever little boy. He'd like for people to think that I'm ill.
Okay, Claire, now I think I'm wrong about what I said. I think there is somebody we should tell.
Who?
A doctor.
Okay, stop the car. Stop the car. You know, if this is the way that you feel about it, Marion, then I am getting out.
Claire, you are really scaring me.
Okay, you want me to see a doctor? Fine. Let's go.
Okay.
Which way? I'll tell you when to turn. Right here.
Claire, this isn't right. What are you thinking?
They know something here. Dr. Jeter. Dr. Jeter. Milo's father. Do you remember this place?
Please, let's go. Claire, you are not going in that room.
Do you remember the jars?
The jars?
They were right here. He was an abortionist, wasn't he? Dr. Jeter, that's what he did.
Come on, let's go.
Wait, what's in here?
The house? Claire, I am getting the hell out of here.
Can I help you with something?
I have a problem.
Please, Miss Mullins, those files are confidential. Your friend here is very worried about you.
I've seen your son.
I hardly think so. My son drowned many years ago. You know that. What is it that you want here?
He's still alive.
Claire, let's go.
I think you should come with me. Look, I'm very sorry about what happened to that little girl, your friend. And to you. Hardly a day passes that I don't think about that night. But my son is dead. He drowned. You saw. Everyone saw. Everyone knows what happened. It ruined my practice. It ruined my life. The shame, the guilt, the pranks with the whole town coming out and gawking. I thought all that was over years ago. I don't understand why you're here now. I don't understand.
Your son is still alive.
Claire, that is enough.
You want to see my son? Come with me. Here's my boy.
No. No.
I found him 5 weeks later. Blue, bloated, putrefied. Do you want me to get you a shovel?
No. 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 I know you did. I can tell by the expression on your face.
Yeah, I want you over this thing. Okay, you know what? Now we're gonna see. Marion? God, Marion, are you out here? Marion, answer me.
Here you go, Miss Mullins. Why'd you have a seat? Take her load off. Now, Miss Mullins, about that story you told us, I went and did some checking. Poked around in some of our dusty old files and found a few things that shed some light on this case. Would you like me to share them with you?
Yes, of course.
All right. Well, the kid you say has been stalking you. Milo, the kid that attacked both your friends, Abigail and Marion. He snatched them up, right?
Right, and Ruth, too.
Mm-hmm. Well, Here he is. Now, why don't you take a good hard look? Because that's your boogeyman, one Milo Jeter, and that's the way they found him. Drowned, and as you can see, very, very dead. A long, long time ago. Now, Miss Mullins, there's more to this little story that you forgot to mention. It probably just slipped your mind. It's easy to do. 16 years ago, you were one of those little girls that Milo attacked. Now, how come you didn't mention that?
I didn't think it would matter.
Really?
Look, I don't understand. What are you trying to say?
What I'm saying is that I have a problem and I'm looking right at her. See, we got a nice little town here. Everybody's friendly, everybody's neighborly. The biggest trouble we usually handle is a lost dog. And then you show up. Like you're returning to the scene of a childhood crime or something. And then all of a sudden, it seems like wherever you go, there's missing people and pools of blood. It just doesn't add up, and that's my problem.
Look, I did not do this. Can't you understand this? He did this. You have to believe me.
Why?
Because you do.
Uh-huh. Well, one way or another, we're gonna put this puppy to bed in the next couple of days. So, Miss Mullins, do me a favor. Don't leave town. You and me, we got some talking to do.
Please. No, I... No. Yes, yes, at the school this evening. Yeah. Okay, do you promise? Okay.
Police came by and we talked.
Yeah, we did too.
They all in a pucker over those deaths.
I know, they don't believe a word I told them. They don't believe Milo's real. What do you think?
Well, I'd like to believe you. I really would.
There's been an accident.
No. Oh my God. What happened?
Yeah, one of our school buses jumped a curb. Kids got bounced around pretty good, but I think everybody's gonna be okay. I decided to call off school for the day, though.
Does anybody know what happened?
No. No one saw anything.
Oh, you little fucker, Milo.
Miss Mullins, yeah, do me a favor. Could you look after your class until all the parents arrive?
Yeah, of course. Okay, everybody button up. Nobody leaves. Evan, don't talk to him anymore. Promise me. Promise me you won't talk to him anymore.
Talk to who?
Evan, please.
Why should I?
He's an evil little boy, Evan. He's dangerous. Stick with your own friends.
But, Miss Mullins, I don't have any friends.
What about me? Jeter, thank you for coming. There was really no one else that I could call.
What's this about?
You said that you were sorry about my friend, the little 10-year-old that Milo killed. Now 3 more of my friends are dead. And there's no doubt that my kids are at risk. And nobody believes me. No one will listen to me. Please stay so that I am not alone in this thing. I mean, my God, he's your son. You have to recognize your own son, and they have to believe you. This has to stop. With your help, nobody else has to die. Please. I don't know where else to turn.
Okay.
You want to come here? Don't make me run. All right, so that'll be enough. Please.
What is this?
Come here, you little shit.
Man's not going to make it to the hospital.
No. No, not here.
You can think about yourself later. Help me. Come on, Mr. Kelso.
Careful. Mr. Kelso.
Miss Mullins. Miss Mullins, please.
Never liked you, Gina.
You remember me then, Mr. Kelso?
Never forget a kid. You're a creepy kid.
How's that?
You're too goddamn clean.
Thank you.
This is him, isn't it? This is Milo. This is your son.
I have to get him upstairs.
No. Tell me. Say it. I have to hear somebody say it.
What did you think he was, a ghost?
He's one of them, isn't he?
What?
The date on that jar. That's his birthday, isn't it? And one of those girls in the file is his mother. Does she know what you have done?
She's dead. And anyway, I wouldn't give her too much credit. All she could produce was stillborn. I delivered a birth.
A monster!
There were some regrettable side effects, I will admit. But you made him a monster. You and your little friends. After what happened, I had to lock him away. He blames you. I blame you.
Mr. Kelso! What have you done to him?
Nothing. But I don't think he's going to pull through.
your wedding day.
Thank you. God! What did you do?
Come on. Oh, God.
kids.